Hi everyone, Dave Verdun here from innovationtutorials.com, making innovation practical. So the Kano model, in a nutshell, helps you understand that there's five different categories a customer needs and how each of them have a different influence on satisfaction. The Kano Survey is a method for actually determining which of your customer needs fall into which of those five categories. And this is important for two main reasons. One, you need to sort these requirements to make sure you're adequately covering the important three categories and minimizing the other two categories. And two, depending on which category the needs fall into, that'll help dictate what action you take. So in this video tutorial, you'll learn a lot of things. First, we're going to do a little review of the Kano model and some basic VOC strategies and best practices. But then we'll talk about what the Kano survey is, how to conduct a Kano survey, how to design a Kano questionnaire, how to evaluate and interpret the results of a Kano survey, and we'll talk about some prerequisites on how to effectively prepare for the Kano survey and give you some advice that makes your Kano efforts, that not only the survey, but the voice of customer in general, more effective. The whole tutorial is about 40 minutes long, so let's get started.
Four is test and administer the Kano survey. Five is tabulate and analyze the results. And six is to decide how to act on the results. Also consider internal customers or partners inside your company, manufacturing, shipping and distribution, logistics. It can be split between rational left brain functional type needs and emotional relationship or right brain type needs. Outside of that layer are four main and C represents wants or needs that the customers ask for, but they won't appreciate. We like to define appreciate as things that customers are willing to pay for. In a little bit, I'll show you some examples of open-ended questions. The second main technique, very good technique, is observational research. Here's where you focus on what people do. Why did you buy your widget over the competitors? What problems have you encountered in the past? What are you expecting in the future that may affect the use or functionality of your widget? Here are the classic responses for the two Kano questions developed by Professor Kano. I like it that way. It must be that way. I am neutral. I can live with it that way. And I dislike it. Many Kano surveyors come up with alternative wording that still preserves Kano's goal but makes it easier for the respondents to answer. How do you feel when your laptop battery lasts more than 5 hours? Love to have it that way. How do you feel when your laptop battery only lasts 1 hour or less? I'd hate to have it that way. This is the Kano evaluation table, which decodes the responses into the proper classification. On the left side are the functional responses, and on the top are the dysfunctional responses. Before launching any survey to the masses, you should test it for timing, confusing questions, confusing instructions, general feedback on its design, and any other problems the customer may have. You may also want to test the step five is to tabulate and analyze the results. After decoding the classification of all of the needs and attributes for each one of the respondents, the combined results should be, but better than that is to create a customer satisfaction coefficient chart, which gives you a little higher resolution analysis of the results. Let me show you how that works. 30 excitement plus 140 performance divided by 221 total responses gives you the average. So if you do well on customer need 1 or 12, you're going to get an item that ends up in the middle, like number 24, doesn't have a strong Kano classification and has a mid-level influence. This means to look at the importance, satisfaction, and Kano classifications simultaneously. Columns G and H are satisfaction levels for your biggest competitors. And in the same light, if you don't have any competitors,